All right, guys, as promised, I said I was gonna make a second part to this. Right, now you can see what I'm talking about, how I made it to where it almost pinches this plastic rod that comes straight down vertically between the plate. I had to dremel some of that out, like I said, just enough to where it would pinch onto that plastic piece. And as you can see, it's pretty much boxed in because of the fair lane. It's on the bumper so it don't go down. Up here with the screw coming down, it tightens it up. And as you can see, that's in there. I'm moving the whole frame when I move the winch. The winch is not even budging at all out of here whatsoever. So, I mean, she's in there. The only downfall is whenever you do an internal winch like this, unless you change it up, is you're gonna have the winch come straight out of the body. I'm pretty sure you probably could take an X-Acto knife, maybe a small razor blade, cut a square notch there so the hook would come in and out. But me, I just wanted to make it look kind of interesting, so I just went with a small hole, drilled hole, took an X-Acto knife and cleared it away. You know, made it look kind of clean, kind of clean cut, if you will. And that's how I made it work with that. Now the lines, I made it come up over into the battery tray, my little white Fairlane, or not Fairlane, why do I keep saying that? I gotta get off of that term. But the little white connections right here to run off into meet up to your wireless tray here. Then from there, I went back around because there was so much slack, I didn't want it to droop for my secondary battery pack in the back. So it gives me a little bit of weight in the rear of this truck. So it should give me a pretty decent optimum clearance and traction on the ground. As you can see, I mean, it works. That's all that matters.